guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel, guys. In today's video, guys, if you have a Chevy vehicle, guys, and you have a transmission leak, transmission fluid leak, we'll explain the common cause for that, guys, and what to look for. We'll be working on a Chevy Cruze, guys, but many vehicles will be that way nowadays. Now, well, guys, okay, let me introduce you quick to the channel, guys. We'll have more than 200 videos on every vehicle we get. Why? Because our goal, guys, is to save you as much money as we can. So please subscribe to the channel, guys. Also, we just started a brand new channel called Electrical Car Repair Life. We'll have quite a few electrical videos, testing components, engine codes, and things like that. So if you have a Chevy vehicle, guys, and you're developing transmission fluid leak from somewhere, We'll show you guys the most common places that it can happen. So this is your radiator, car radiator. On most Chevy vehicles, the transmission cooler is part of the radiator. You can see this is the transmission line. Okay, one on top, one on the bottom. And the coolant actually is the one that cools your transmission as well. Now, you will notice, guys, okay, the most common leak will be from here, and we will show you where, and stay with us until the end to show you two more places where you can develop a transmission fluid leak. Now, first, okay, let us show you now, okay, we're going to show you how that transmission line goes in the fitting, but you have a fitting that the transmission line attaches to the radiator. Usually it's like a 19 millimeter or something like that. And that fitting, guys, okay, it has two O-rings. One on the outside, okay, that black one that could develop a leak. And one on the inside. That one on the inside is the one that goes in the line, guys. The line goes in it. So if that O-ring is not good, it's not going to seal. And as a result, guys, you're going to develop a leak from the coolant line. Okay, usually the coolant line attaches with this spring. Okay, like that. And if everything's good, if that O-ring is good, if the one on the inside that we showed you is good, everything will be fine, guys. Okay, and we don't need to worry about that leaking. However, now, okay, we're going to remove the radiator and we're going to show you where else, okay, you can, guys, develop a leak quick. So, let's pull this transmission line out. Okay, we're going to turn the radiator a little bit so I can gain a little bit more room. And usually the transmission line, sometimes they have extension lines. Okay, let me get down there, I cannot show you. Okay, you can see these two. Okay, this one and this one there, guys. Those, they have the same O-rings like the one on top. So you can develop a leak there as well, guys. And the third place will be your transmission lines go in the transmission. These two lines, you have two O-rings there as well. So any of those three places, guys, it's a very common problem for a Chevy to start leaking transmission fluid if you have a higher mileage vehicle. So hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to some of you. Please, guys, hit that subscribe button for more videos, and see you guys next time.